Now, let us log in and create a user. The plan is to make this user a schema by creating at least one object for it. So let us log in. I'm going to call this user as TST, referring to the word test, which is T-E-S-T. Create user test identified by test 567. What this means is test will be the name of the user that we create. Again, TST. Okay. The identified by class refers the method by which this user will be authenticated. Giving a string value like test 567 means that test 567 will be the password for this user. Now, using this SQL developer window, let us try to connect. Username is test, password is test 567. Let me test the connection. So what happens? We are not able to connect because the user has not been given permission to connect to the database, though it has been created. Now, let us grant that permission. Grant connect to test. Now let's try again. Success. Save the password and connect. So now I see two connections. This one, I use it for system connection. And this one is the new one, which logs me in as the user test. Thank you.